But we start with what could be the beginning of the end for the NFL lockout. Right now, team owners, including Saints owner Tom Benson, meeting in Atlanta.
And they're about to vote on that new labor deal that would return players and coaches to the field. WDSU sports anchor Fletcher Mackel is in Atlanta and joins us live now with the latest on these negotiations. Fletcher?
Scott and Camille, the NFL lockout has lasted 132 days, and the NFL owners that are meeting in the hotel behind me say they don't want it to last 133 days. Team owners from all 32 teams began arriving at 9 a.m. this morning. They have been behind closed-door meetings all day, taking only one break, and one owner says they won't leave until a deal is done. Saints owner Tom Benson entered the NFL owners' meetings here in Atlanta, Georgia, with one thing on his mind. Do you think we're going to get a deal today?
Hey, we got to get a deal done today, right?
A deal?
Okay.
Heavenly news for football fans who've been following the 132-day lockout very closely. The NFL owners are expected to announce any moment they voted and approved a new 10-year labor deal. The owners are, in essence, throwing the touchdown pass, but will the players receive it?
Well, the pressure's now transitioned to the players, because with the owners now ready to vote this in, now it's going to be a matter of the players having their vote to see if they're going to recertify the union, because this successful vote by the owners doesn't mean anything if the players don't vote it back in, because the one thing is they're voting in as a union. So first, the board has to, at least on the Thursday night vote, vote that in and then take it to the 1,900 players and have a 50% plus one vote to try to keep that going. And so in a lot of ways, this is a good faith effort by the owners to take it to one step. Now it's a matter to players to deliver their part and have a union so they can have a league.
I think what's clear is this is the first time that there's real stakes. I mean, the NFL has said, oh, we could lose money. The sponsors aren't signing the deals we want, but they're going to sign the deals when the season starts. Now we have stakes. If something's not done by tomorrow, we lose that Hall of Fame game on August 7th.
And now two quick items to talk about. Many here are telling us that to recertify as a union, which the NFL players have to do, some people say that could take hours, others say it could take days. And then the big question is, what happens as far as free agency, the draft, and filling out rosters? Well, we're going to talk more about that at 6 o'clock. And I should also point out that it looks like there is some activity behind us, so perhaps the owners have voted and they have reached an agreement, or they have at least voted on their side of the agreement. We'll hustle back in after we finish this Q&A and find out what's going on.
Yeah, one more thing before you run off, Fletcher. We saw Tom Benson look pretty confident. The players seem confident, but is this something, if the owners have voted now, the players could vote by the end of the day today or tonight, and it could be over today, or will this drag on a few more days? What's your sense?
That's the big question. Will the owners vote tonight? Some reports from the NFL Network say the players could vote as soon as 8 o'clock tonight, but then other reports say that it could go into Friday or Saturday. I'm getting the sense from talking to people here that it may be early tomorrow, but we shall see.
All right. We will continue to follow your tweets and your live reports during our newscast. Thanks very much, Fletcher. This